What's up, everybody? It's your boy D coming at you with another episode of the D Experience. Today, we're going to talk about how quarantine has let out all of these different movies for us to watch right now. And I've been watching everything that I can get my hands on. But one thing that I wasn't expecting was Angel Has Fallen. Angel Has Fallen is the third movie in the, I guess, Fallen franchise, starting with Olympus Has Fallen, then followed by London Has Fallen, and now here we have Angel Has Fallen. It stars Gerard Butler and Morgan Freeman. All I can say is that this is Gerard Butler's franchise. This is his Die Hard, his Terminator, his Rambo. This is his franchise. He doesn't have to really go out into anything else because when you know what this character can do. That being said, this is probably a sign of diminishing returns based off of the size of each of the movies. The first movie was in the White House. It was him versus an army in the White House. Made perfect sense. It went the route it was supposed to. It was directed by Antoine Fuqua. I don't want to say the director because I'm not sure. But I remember it was bigger budget, but it was like compact, the area. But the action was great in it. Second movie, Olympus Has Fallen. You have a city. You go from a building to a city. Different director, action was still there, and it still had a good enough plot that you understand it. This one, on the other hand, it's like the whole East Coast store or a certain area, and it's too big to contain enough action in spots. It's too spread out for me. The last third of the movie is what brings it on home, and it reminds you of what the original movie was. This pretty much takes place in the hospital, and that shows you that that's probably what they wanted to do in the first place, but they had to get from point A to point B to get to this. Unfortunately, a lot of the rest of the movie is very predictable. Within 5 minutes of seeing the movie, I was like, okay, I know this guy. He's going to turn on him. He never plays a good guy. It was that easy to realize what was going to happen. It also wasted Jada Pinkett Smith. She doesn't get in a lot of movies. She's in this one barely. I think she must have got paid by the line because she must only have like 20 lines in the whole movie. Same thing with Morgan Freeman, who's now the president, if you remember the first two movies. But the action is good when they do it. What I love is that they use practical effects. I love action movies that use practical effects. It looks real. It gives the movies a realistic feel. And you realize that they've had probably a smaller budget, but more area to work with. And because of that, some of the scenes don't feel as compact and it spreads it out. It can help it, but it also hurts it because it lets the action scenes not go as long and they are really, 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 really spread out. It also introduces a new character to the whole Bannon family, and you all kind of get the idea where it comes from, and you're like, okay, like I said, one of the downsides is it's very predictable, but this is the perfect movie to watch right now to kill 2 hours if you ain't got anything to do. A lot of us don't right now. Check out Angel Has Fallen, especially if you like a gun enthusiast. Sound editing, perfect. Like, it sounds like, okay, these are how the guns are supposed to sound. I got a few friends that I know, they will probably be like, yeah, you know what, that was really good. Reminded me of a Den of Thieves in that sense. But if you're looking for something to keep you entertained and on the edge of your seat the entire movie, this ain't the one. It just doesn't have that type of action. All in all, good flick. I give it a 6 out of 10. Something to just have in the background and kind of play on TV if you ain't got nothing to do and just want to kill 2 hours. That's going to do it for me. I'll see you all next time. I'm out. Peace.